As far as they know, and there's a giant whale-like creature swimming alongside of them with a woman and four children and a tarbol.
And a ghost bird.
On its back.
And a ghost bird.
And a ghost bird.
Bird. Okay. And bear.
And a bear. Bear. Yes, okay. The bear is there too.
Yeah. All right. Sorry. So, you guys do anything or just continue sailing?
I think we should just continue keeping course as things are, the weather's good, the whales keeping us company. I think we should just continue course.
So I'm aware of the whale now.
Yeah, I think okay. Aware of the
whale. After we jumped on the deck, I think you guys did.
Everyone make a perception check.
I'm so good at perception. I'm sorry, man.
Is Owen helping?
Yeah, Owen can help you.
Well, two. That's not that great.
Two.
Two is for me as well. Two and two, as I say.
Where'd my dice go? Here they are.
Seven.
Okay.
Whoa! Perception is my thing. I'm very perceptive.
I got a one.
Okay.
You are not very perceptive.
No, I'm not.
You notice a giant storm on the horizon.
Oh.
Like a lot of lightning. You tell anybody here.
She tells no one.
Yeah.
She tells Jaden.
Yeah, that's the thing. Well, obviously Omen knows, and he can talk to the ghost bear, and the ghost bear tells Miles, and then Miles tells everybody else. So it's this big chain of talking.
So everyone knows there's a storm approaching.
There's a storm approaching.
Or actually, you guys are sailing into a storm, I should say.
Alright.
We're sailing into a storm.
There's no way to avoid it or anything?
It's right in the... Basically, it's a long wall of storm that's in the direction that you're heading. You can't... And it's like stretches as far right as it does left that you can see.
Alright. I'm no sailor, but I've heard it's a good idea to take the sails down during these types of storms.
This is true.
Yes, and we should also tell York to come down from the crow's nest.
York.
And then, yes, sir,
what is a crow's nest?
It's where all the crows are.
Where a person sits atop of sail mast so they can see higher up.
What would they call it if they actually kept a nest for crows on a ship? What would they call that?
Like someone the brought, next dinner.
Crows are very intelligent.
Take the bat.
They're not dinner.
Take the hatches and also batten them.
Okay. So what does that mean exactly?
Yeah,
lock
I don't know.
The doors so they don't get blown around.
Alright. So you're locking up the ship. Everyone, roll an intelligence check to see if you understand how to do this well.
What are we doing?
I'm so intelligent. I got a one.
Make sure you got sails down and tied in place, everything's battened, all the hatches.
I got a negative one.
I got a two.
Are we still on the whale, or?
Well, I assume you were getting back on the boat because the whale's kind of a dangerous place.
Can I, like, climb in the whale's mouth and he can keep me safe?
I would not trust that whale. How long have you known this guy?
I feel safer on the inside of the whale than I do on this boat.
Crazy.
Okay, fine. We go and we board up the boat.
I got a two.
Five. John.
I got a negative one.
Negative one.
I got three.
Sorry, what?
Three.
Ronnie?
Got a one.
One? All right. Tony got most of it. A few other people helped.
The four children are just running around and closing doors.
So you're getting closer to the storm. Is there anything else you're doing in the meantime?
Going under the ship.
Going under the ship?
As if
you're jumping off and like swimming underneath?
No. He's going into the hold of the ship. I'm going to take a rope and tether myself to the mast.
Okay.
I am bracing all of my potions and stuff like that to make sure they're not going to slosh around and just kind of securing everything.
That's a good idea.
Make a... We'll just say an intelligence check to see if you... How well you secure them, how well you can figure out to secure them. John, what are you doing?
Me? I'm gonna go below the deck. Where it's like safe.
Laura?
Five.
Okay. They're fairly well secured.
Also, by below the boat, I meant below the deck.
I know.
Yes.
I
know. You're in the holding ship, Richard. It's okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, we're at the time of night where my brain starts to function less effectively.
Relevant skills for the whole boat thing. So, mostly with the looking around thing. But, I think I'm chilling and putting my flask away because the alcohol and the seasickness is not a good combination. So,
stop drinking.
I am stopping drinking.
Good.
That's the point.
Now I'm drinking coffee.
Okay.
Now you're finally drinking the coffee I brewed for you.
Okay. And you ride into the storm. There's lightning everywhere, shooting, like hitting the water all around you. Torrential downpour, strong 40 mile an hour winds, if you could measure them. Tony, roll a navigation check or a steering check.
Oh, you gotta be. Are you up there steering the ship?
Six.
Okay. You're holding it together really well.
Keep it together.
What was the whale's name? It was like Evan or something.
Ethan,
thank you.
But as you're sailing your boat, you're able to keep it, you know, hit the waves just right where you're staying above. But then lightning strikes the sail and it catches on fire.
What?
Okay. With mainsail, I guess?
Yeah.
Wait! We took the sails down!
We did, but...
Oh, wait, you don't take sails down.
You tether them to the mast.
Tie them up.
So it's the mast.
It is a mast, okay.
Yeah. All right.
I'm below deck.
Yeah, me too.
What do you do about that, other than hope that the rain of the storm will extinguish?
Steer us into a giant wave.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good idea. I just got a thought.
Mind calm.
For my not mind calm.
Okay, so you're trying to steer into a wave?
Oh, you could surf the boat on the waves.
Five.
Hey, friend, do you want to make drug coffee?
Okay,
to try and get a little bit of extra wave.
Why not?
On top of the,
Because I'm not a drug
It's close, but
maker.
You barely managed to do it.
Okay.
Make another sailing check.
What'd you roll?
Nine.
Dude, that was a good roll.
You're doing really well. You're sailing through. You guys are getting battered around in the below deck. And everyone below deck, make a perception check.
I'm below deck. I'm looking around. I don't see anything because I rolled really bad.
One.
I got a one.
I got a
1-1-1.
I got three.
Three. Right? 1-1-1-3?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
Three ones and a three.
You notice some water kind of started sliding past your shoes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. There's a lot of water.
Yeah.
It's storming quite a lot.
We're in an ocean.
Yeah, but this isn't the water dripping from above.
It's not.
Where is it coming from?
The space towards the front of the boat.
I feel like in a storm of this magnitude, there's already water everywhere, so I'm not sure if I'm really perceiving where the water's coming from.
Well, there's definitely a flow of water coming from the front of the boat.
Well, I'm gonna investigate.
Okay.
Follow it.
You're investigating, you're following it. You open the door to the room with one of the cannons on the right side.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just completely, about a foot of water just cascades out, and you notice that John apparently mistied down the cannon.
What?
In preparation.
Bro, come on.
And it broke a hole, not a huge hole, but it's definitely bringing water in.
Come on, man.
Hey, I should never have been given that responsibility.
You gotta tie that stuff down, mm-hmm. Right.
Okay.
It was my manager's fault, not mine.
Is that me?
I guess so.
I feel like a parent figure is definitely a manager, yes.
I don't think I'm going to be able to fix this on my own. I'm going to send Omen to report. If he can't communicate with any of these guys, he can at least communicate the spirit bearer who will communicate with these guys.
Okay.
Spirit bearer.
So he sends the message, and I guess I can use my water stone to try to hold the water back?
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Cool.
So you give me a fake?
Yeah. I don't know what else to do with that.
Yeah. So you activate the water stone, and you're actually shoving the water back, and you're basically making it create some kind of a wall so that the water can't come in, but there's only so long you can hold that.
And freeze it. Freeziness. Although that still wouldn't hold forever, but still.
Yeah, and I'll give you that, and it actually freezes it in place. But that cannon's still rolling around.
Yeah.
Ronnie, your bear's talking to the owl, and then the bear talks to you and says there's a hole in the boat in the cannon room. The front cannon room, we're on the right side.
I think this is rather troubling.
Yeah.
So this is just the cannon, if you put the cannon back, wouldn't it just stop it?
No, the cannon's just kind of rolling around freely, and it...
I didn't secure it.
He didn't secure it, so it bashed a hole in the side of the hole.
And it's still rolling around.
Yeah.
Okay, then. Looks like I'm going to go get my... So it has wheels on it, right?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay.
Yes, but they're cannon wheels. So.
Take off those wheels, man.
Just be careful.
Just be careful of the cannon wheel.
Yeah, it's a cannon, man.
It is loaded as well, so. Because I keep them loaded.
Yeah, he made a specific point to say that they were all preloaded.
Yeah.
So be careful.
I'm going to go down there in the suit, and I'm just going to take the wheels off the cannon so it stops moving.
Okay. Do you tell them what's going on?
I just tell them on the way.
Okay.
So the cannon came undone. It was not securely...
Yeah, we don't know how that happened, but yes, that is the case.
And it broke a hole in sheep. I'm going to go down, take wheels off of there before it breaks other holes. I would recommend someone else coming down to help repair sheep to make sure water doesn't keep coming in.
Why don't I?
Well, I'm already down there with you, so... I'll help you out.
All right,
Ronnie, roll a strength check to rip the wheels off.
Jeez, violence.
That's what he's good at.
Yeah.
I'm strong.
Strong. Not like that.
I have 6 strong.
He's got 6.
This many.
This many strong.
I gave him a quarter.
Yeah, you ripped those wheels off.
But good for the 6.
Did you come with him?
No.
Okay.
He's still
John, did yes. you come with him?
Yeah, yeah, I was with him.
What are you doing?
I'm just like, you know, behind him, like making sure everything is good. Like okay. he's got that secured,
that
right?
Needs fixed.
Yes. Right what? Now it's a rapidly melting ice wall that's.
It's gonna crack before it melts.
Yeah.
Is there any spare wood or anything nearby?
There's all kinds of splinters of wood and everything.
Just patch the ship. Intelligence, right?
To be able to build.
Yeah, but I mean, most of the wood that's in there is what didn't get washed out when it got, when the ship got, or when the hull was broken. So basically some of the wood got washed out, what didn't is mostly just like splinters and stuff.
Is there any spare wood in the ship anywhere?
You can do a search check.
Wait, hold on. Are there like tables and stuff like that in there, or any
in the galley?
Galley?
But yeah, there would be tables in the galley.
The galley's under the deck, right?
Yeah, below deck.
So I'm just gonna get a table from the galley right. and block the hole.
Right. Oh, good idea.
Roll your. Actually, we'll do it this way. Roll an intelligence check first to see if you can find the best way to plug it. And then roll a strength check with a -2 because you're trying to patch a hole in the middle of a storm. Anybody want to help
him? Alrighty, so that's
I'll
going
help
to be...
I'm above, so I can't really help.
I'm below.
3 intelligence. And -2. It's going to be a 7 strength.
Okay. You may just get... clogged up, nailed up. You can't use that cannon currently in its current state because you're just trying to completely block it.
Well, I mean, if I have to, I'll just hold it and shoot it at somebody.
But, okay. Tony, make another sailing check. Six. Okay. You're doing good. Everything seems to be going well. But then as you come over a 20-foot tall wave, and basically you're just cresting over the wave, uh-huh. you look down and you see a vortex actually forming in the water ahead of you.
One of those different things called
like a whirlpool. Yeah, a giant whirlpool.
I've been in one of those before, in a different life. There was a goblin throwing fire at me. What's happening? Is there any ability to see? Edge of the storm, or are we in the eye of the storm?
Yes.
You can make a perception check.
If we were in the eye of the storm, there would be less storm.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, I mean, the center of the whirlpool would be the epicenter of the colliding temperature waves, right?
If it was a storm that was causing the whirlpool.
Could be a magic whirlpool. Use magic.
Magic whirlpool. I think that's why I have to use perception.
Reading rainbow. Magic rainbow.
2.
I can fly twice as high.
You can't see the edge.
Take
or the eye.
Can I do perception? I'm good at perception.
Are you going to go above deck to do it?
Well, Owen can go above deck. He's quick. Also,
I'm okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll let you do that. Roll for Owen.
Nine.
Nine?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nine?
You see, or Omen sees, the Eye of the Storm several miles off to the right, which I think technically is south, but to the right, and the edge, and one of the edges basically coming out on the other side in the direction we're heading, is a couple miles ahead as well. Through lightning flashes, he also notices the whirlpool is not naturally generated. As the lightning flashes and lights up the light, he sees a monster bigger than you've ever seen in your life. It literally looks like it's probably about the size of Castle Fianhage.
That's bigger than Ethan?
Yes, much bigger. Like,
so Ethan
four probably like 10 times.
The Ethan's time. Gone. He's like, see ya.
Did Ethan evolve?
See you guys.
Yeah.
We like Ethan.
We were friends.
All you can really see of it.
Can we befriend it?
This giant gaping mouth with many rows of teeth going up.
No.
It's sucking. As its maw opens, that's what's causing the whirlpool to suck down.
Oh, that's that monster from Greek mythology.
It's the Kraken!
Oh, wait, we need to find Medusa.
Is the owl going to warn me at all?
I mean, he obviously tells me because we're psychically linked. I don't know where I am in relation to you.
You're underneath, I'm above.
Yeah. I'm below deck. And he's below deck, and I don't know where the bear is.
I'm below deck.
The bear probably came back with me.
Yeah. Well, I guess I can go above deck and start shouting at people. That's probably what I'm going to do.
Okay, so you make a dexterity check to try to make your way over to Tony so you can speak to him.
Yeah. That's a one.
A one? Okay, you get about two steps out, and a wave crashes over you, and you notch you off your feet, and you slam into the side of the boat.
Ouch.
Make another one.
I don't like boats. I would rather just shoot people. That was a three.
Three? Okay, you get about halfway to Tony. Make another one.
Sure. That's a one. I'm having a hard time. I'm a little bit seasick here. Yeah.
You can do it, Flower Mom.
I need more coffee.
I believe in you.
Okay, so...
if Omen drinks coffee, will it be generated to you?
One of the masks breaks and like swings around and smacks you and make another...
Dexterity check.
Yeah, make another dexterity check to try to grab a hold and not fall off the boat.
That's a four.
A four? Okay, you manage to grab a hold of the edge before you go over. Make another dexterity check to try to finish the distance.
Is anyone helping me?
I see her being swatted around?
Like, I'm below decks right now.
You can make a perception check, but it's really stormy out there and you're really focused on trying to
not die.
Yeah.
You're above decks, right?
I'm up there. I'm tied to the mast.
Does he untie himself?
Three for perception, wisdom.
Okay. Yeah. You can just barely see her.
I see something getting swatted around.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know it's human.
Where is my brother?
I'm not aware of that. I am down trying to...
Are you below decks?
I'm below decks, where everyone should be. I don't understand why.
Right. Maybe I'll get... Anything to try to reach her, or...
I can try to reach out to the end of my tether.
Oh, can I feel, like, you know, like she's Leia, and I can feel that she's in danger?
Do that. Psychic sibling bond.
So what are you doing?
Huh? Are we Jedi? Can I feel, like...
Pulse
The Leia, Leia is, can I call her Leia now?
Roll a wisdom check.
Do I get to do that too? I like wisdom.
I need some force powers. Build me a lightsaber.
Yeah, sure. Roll your wisdom check. Yes! These two can meet.
If we roll the exact same, oh, that's not very good.
I got
a one.
I got a three. Combined, we have a four.
Wonder Twins powers activate.
All right.
You sense that something's wrong with her. You can't tell exactly what it is, but you do sense something's wrong with her.
It could just be like that, you know, she
Angel Robinson
hasn't had her coffee. She's just hungover. Maybe a little seasick on top of that.
Roll another dexterity check. You get a plus two because Tony is trying to reach you.
Oh, that was really nice. So three plus two. I got an eight.
Okay, you manage to reach him, and he helps tie you down to the mast with it as well.
Well, I guess we're chatting now.
Yeah, we're going to have to.
Yeah.
What are you doing up here? I thought everybody was below deck.
Yeah, that's a good question. So what do you recommend, Space Daddy?
Space Daddy. Yeah.
Space Daddy. Is there new information that I need to know?
Yes, there is. The Eye of the Storm, we said, was miles that away.
Yeah.
Yes. And
then what is this large whirlpool?
There is a giant monster.
Creature.
This giant gaping maw with many, many rows of teeth in there. My skills are more in the military.
We could throw a bunch of mushrooms down those mouth hole.
Monster area, so.
We need to communicate with the people below deck to take the two cannons that are on the left side.
Okay.
And put them out. Lock, cock, ready to blow. I'm going to steer the ship into the top of the vortex so that we're pointed at an angle so those cannons are directly facing towards the center of the whirlpool.
Okay.
And I want them to fire those cannons into the center of the whirlpool, A, to do damage, B, to try and give us enough momentum to lift us up and out of the whirlpool on the opposite
give
side.
Give you a reverse momentum?
Something like that.
Okay. Make a pilot check with a minus four penalty, because that's a hard maneuver to do. And you can help him if you want.
What am I doing?
Like, helping him.
Did you just say teamwork and you give me a two?
I don't know anything.
So she gives me a two?
Yeah.
Five.
Five, okay. And you guys got... I'm guessing your bear's up on deck and can sense what he's saying. He comes down and tells you what's going on. I need all of you to roll strength checks to try to get the cannons in place.
I'm good at this.
Yeah, I have you bound.
Okay. Five. Never mind. I'm not too exceptionally good at this anymore.
Oh, I'm super strong. Let's see.
That's what I said, and then I got a...
I got a three.
Oh, I got a five.
And five. Okay. So that's 17 total. All right. You got the... you absolutely got the cannons in place.
Now we kill everything.
That's a big mood right there, bucko.
So you're sailing, you're, bleh. Okay. You're both basically
sailing away.
Completely
capsized.
Almost. Yeah, sideways on the, as it's getting sucked in. They manage to shift the cannons out and fire a volley, which doesn't seem to really hurt this ginormous monster much. But it does shift the boat just ever so slightly to the right, which is just a little bit further out again. Tony, roll another minus four pilot check. I'm guessing you're still giving him...
Give him the plus two. Why not?
Yeah.
Five.
Five? All right. You three. Fire. Roll strength to aim the cannons.
10.
Six.
Six. John?
I'm rolling. My strength is 3.
3?
Yep.
That's nearly exactly what you guys rolled last time. Again, no real damage to it, but it pushes you a little bit further over again. One more.
Boom, boom, psh, boom, boom. Okay, this is it, boys. Oh, no, it's not. 2.
6.
10. Sorry, what?
That's pretty good, Ronnie.
There's a 6 and a 5.
Yeah. The rainstorm's going to measure. So 5, and then you guys will what?
6.
10. Oh, John?
I rolled a 2.
Pretty much the exact same thing again. You managed to fire one more time, which just barely gets you over the lip of the whirlpool, and you're sailing, and you manage to, a few hours later, manage to actually get out of the storm.
Whew.
The ship's a little battered and bruised, but you're alive.
Sweet action, Jackson. That's not as scary as flying in space, but we made it through. I'm proud of us.
I'm proud of us.
Space Daddy is proud of me.
Space
Well,
Daddy.
Most of you. The monkey didn't help.
The monkey did help? What are you talking about?
I saw the monkey eating bananas.
It aimed the cannons.
It sat atop the cannon and went...
Clean for lunch.
It looks good!
No, I'm just imagining it accidentally climbing onto the cannonball and being launched into
it. Your monkey's gonna get us all killed.
Oh, it's okay. That's completely fine with me.
You guys are
put your monkey away.
Are you guys doing anything for the next 3 days as you continue to sail?
I think that
taking a nap.
Professor Runstrom and Dr. Miles are probably maneuvering around the ship with Jaden trying to make repairs.
Jaden Smith.
Listens and we say no. Like this, and we supervise this time to
he
make sure.
He slaps hand with the ruler.
Yes, with a splinter of wood.
What did I tell you about firing those cannons?
That's not what management said.
There's no such thing as a bad student.
And start moving in more. And it's just basically back out. I mean, you can't get it 100% while you're still out at sea, but it's close enough to that to top setting. And you sail for another 3.
It's not dead, but we are out of the storm.
You guys managed to get out of the whirlpool and get out of the storm.
I still left you tied to the post.
Oh, okay.
For 3 days.
I'm getting figurehead. Thank you.
About 3 days later, you hear, "Land ahoy!" from the crow's nest.
What? There's not supposed to be anything out here.
But I heard Mr. York say that he sees land. So either we have come to the end of your map, as if we're flat earth.
Let me check the map.
Or we have come full circle to the other side of land, or, third option, there is island out here.
Let's see here.
We're either here, or we're at an island that we did not know of.
We've discovered a new world.
A new world for you and me.
What shall we call it?
We will call it the Isle of J. Duncan.
I don't get an isle.
I like it.
That seems a bit much.
J sis. We will ship you together. But not into the weird shipping.
I feel like that was a weird shipping.
Technically siblings if we were, born from a font of magic.
I think if you're born from the same font of magical energy, then you share a connection with that same energy.
Well, what would our generic heritage be? Where did Are we genetically perfect?
I think that you should.
You've never tested your genetics.
I don't think you should combine your genetics.
That would crack the world open.
Right. That would separate the continents like I wanted.
Which was a terrible idea, by the way.
That teddy bear looks high.
We still have to get to the end of this voyage before we know for certain. Everything's an experiment.
Yor comes down and tells you not only does he see land ahead, but there are people on it. And houses.
There's not supposed to be houses?
Fairly simple. Like, straw.
Oh, it's just simple houses.
So or they're log cabined?
Yeah, pretty much. But for the most part, well, not log, but,
is this, like, Survivor Island kind? Or, like, we're starting a civilization. This is Yorktown.
This is...
We'll call it Yorktown since York found it.
Yeah, exactly.
This is a very...
Yorktown is an actual place.
Shh! Of course it is. We just found it. What are you speaking about?
We are the colonists of Yorktown.
The buildings are very
the Battle
primitive.
Of Yorktown.
It looks like they were made from boats for the most part, but there are a few that were made from like stretched... shark skin or different things like that.
So they have like a church, but instead of a cross at the top, they have like the figurehead of a ship up there or something like that.
Maybe a bell or something. Yeah.
Ding dong, ding dong.
The ground seems to be kind of a...
Is the floor made of lava?
No.
I've trained for this.
No.
My whole life.
Right. The ground, you don't see any trees on it? But you see, like, it looks almost like gray-green clay, but with different sparkling colors all throughout. And as far as you can tell, it's about the size of the native.
Okay, where's my map?
There's, like, and everything inside the castle.
That's a big island.
It's almost equivalent.
There's no place on my map for it.
So it's almost like the planet's trying to balance itself naturally.
Oh, it's like,
so like
coming out. Oh, yeah, I see what you mean.
Arrows is kind of like sucking the magic out of the other end, and we need to like...
stop him.
Yeah. I don't understand. Are we sure he's not the villain?
I don't think he's sure if he's the villain.
I mean, I decided I don't like Feldenay, you know, with her trying to kill me thing. Yeah. There was that.
She's
but,
pretty hot,
no,
though.
No, she's bad.
Yeah, she's bad. She's definitely bad.
She's cray-cray.
But she wasn't entirely wrong about...
She wasn't wrong, but she was not the person to save his place.
Yeah, exactly.
The balance would actually be held by...
Okay, but, like, what if Feldenay is his child?
That would explain why she's so cray-cray. She's got daddy issues.
Exactly.
And Papa's getting drunk on magic water.
Exactly.
Maybe that's the reason you two were born from the font in balance with each other as a yin and a yang to balance the system, to be a magical resource. So if this is energy, it's potential energy, it's ebbing and it's flowing, maybe your job as an entity or a creature on this planet is to control and help push that energy in a controlled manner, but on both sides. So whereas Eris is just sucking up the energy on one side, nobody over here is balancing
there's it. It needs to be a counterbalance.
There has to be a balance and a counterbalance at all times, a yin and a yang, a dark and a light.
Which is which? Who's the dark and who's the light?
Who is the evil one?
No, she's the witch, you're the warlock.
I don't know. What's
I
your
feel like that was very...
Gray and you're...
I am, I do not kill people.
I don't really know what my alignment
he's
is.
He's Rey, she's Kylo Ren.
Yeah, and then we'll have to wait till the movie comes out to
I
see mean, how they're all...
I feel like I'm lawful evil, evil, and then other times I feel like I'm chaotic good, and I really just don't know anymore.
You can be both.
Limelines can be complicated.
Like, can you be, like, good but not lawful good or chaotic good?
Like neutral good?
Yeah.
That's a thing.
I'm neutral good, then.
There you go.
Or is there such a thing as true good?
The truest
good. Like lawful good.
Yeah, but just following the lawful isn't necessarily good.
Chaotic good is you kind of, you do good for goodness sake. You try to, you kind of live by your own morality, but it's in general what people would consider good.
You like are a good person.
Like if you, like if some place has an unjust law, you're against that.
But then also you have to understand, like, different cultures have different, like, you know...
So if it was the law of Hammurabi, he might agree with it. And if he agreed with it and found it to be right, as long as he supported it, that's still lawful good. Even though you're chopping people's hands off.
Well, but then, like, there are limits to that kind of, like, societal law. Like, for example, right? Like, if you steal something to feed...
This isn't pushing the story along.
Well, I was just explaining, my character's explaining lawful good.
Lawful neutral, which is to support order.
I think she's lawful evil and you're lawful good.
But
way, I'm against
I would say I was more chaotic good.
So,
but like, according to his definition. Well, then what's neutral good?
Him.
Neutral is...
No, he is not
me?
Good.
Yeah.
These guys aren't good. He tried to drug us all.
Yeah.
I didn't try
That's not
to
neutral.
Drug you. I asked if you wanted to make drugged coffee.
So you could, like, give it to everyone?
No. Why give them
I'm
the
pretty
drugs?
Sure I remember you, like...
Make John and Laura, make a perception check.
I'm going to perceive...
They don't want drugs. I do.
I perceive four.
Four?
Yes.
Four.
Okay. You both feel really good.
Awesome.
Yeah.
It honestly feels like the closer you get to this island, the stronger you are.
Magic.
The more at peace you are.
Now that we're on the magical island, I kind of like this place. It's pretty. Can it be mine?
It's mine!
It's yours? You can have the castle. Can I have the island?
No, I want the island.
Mm-hmm. But my... What am I doing?
All right, so what are you guys doing?
Are we, like, have we, like, anchored our ship? Are we, like, going to row out to the island?
You tell me.
Well, yeah, we should anchor the ship, set anchor, and then row out to the island.
Make port.
That's cool, by the way.
Captain?
Keep that sounds fair to me. Okay, yeah. You seem giddy. I'm okay with that. I'd like to see what's going on here.
Time to frolic through the magic fields.
I just don't want to pick up my backpack and having anything alive in it.
Yeah. So you drop anchor and paddle out to the island, and everyone's starting to gather the closer you get, and they're just staring at you like you're aliens. And then you.
We're illegal aliens.
Yeah.
What do they look like? They look like...
They look like humans. They look like
other people.
The rest of you.
They are not my kind.
Do they speak our language?
You haven't spoken to anyone yet.
They're just creeping around staring at us.
Yeah.
Well, we're just kind of creeping.
You don't get the sense that they see people very often.
Okay.
That's not part of their group.
Well, can I introduce myself?
Go for it.
I'm Jaden Smith. We came seeking the other side of the world. We didn't expect to find people.
We haven't had any new guests in decades.
I see that your huts and your houses are built from ships. Like, did you come here, like, you know, sailing the sea?
Our parents did. They kind of on the run from the mainland. They said that everyone there hated them and were dead. Is that where you were from?
Yes. Can I, like, search my memory for any kind of...
Search the memory banks.
Memory banks.
The memory banks.
Can I? I'm gonna burn this. I'm gonna reroll.
We'll slide it over.
Yeah. Reroll. That's a little bit better. That would be memory. Would be what? Intelligence or wisdom?
Intelligence.
So that would be two.
Two. You can't really remember any stories. You don't really know much about coming from the Gorbis Forest. You don't really know much about the coast or the waters or.
How long have they been out there? Like when they said their parents, but was that like a full generation or was that like 10 years?
How old do they look?
You ask them. Okay.
Yes.
They say most of us were born here. Our parents came here. At least from the stories they've told us, that they came here about 60 years ago.
Is this another time distortion thing in there?
Time dilation.
Yes. Dilated time is also distorted. Words. Okay. That would have been solid 50 years before Feldane broke from the guard, but obviously not before she was born. She's over 200 years old. So.
Well, she would know, like, if a group of people were forced off the mainland. But then, of course, like basically they were committing suicide because most people believe that going, so like why do they, what drove them off the mainland when they could have just hidden in the desert and much safer than going to the seas?
Yeah.
What was it about the mainland? Oh, by the way, I'm saying all this, like, what are the stories your parents tell?
They said they didn't fit well in with society back home.
Did they know this island was here?
They desired freedom too much.
Like, so they chose death?
Who was it that made you not free? If you desired freedom, what
made you their parents?
Freedom
they
just do what exactly?
Freedom!
Yes, what freedom were your parents trying to seek?
They just wanted to do whatever they wanted.
Like, weird
I like
stuff, or...
Is it magic
what
related?
Is it? Cult.
What is a cult?
Well,
it may be what you are.
Yeah.
They just took whatever they wanted and killed whoever angered them, and that was...
What? You're not supposed to do that.
Yeah.
So...
Guys, that stuff's illegal.
Yeah, that's what I say. That's illegal?
I think we might have to kill them. I'm not going to attack first.
I have to kill you now? Sorry.
Can I see if my bird can detect intention?
That's the way I talk now.
You can attempt to.
We both know that you aren't sorry.
I'm sorry. But I'm sorry.
Sorry, intention if you want. Roll
okay.
Wisdom or charisma.
But not both.
I'm gonna roll wisdom to detect intention.
10.
Oh, I got a really terrible roll.
Okay.
Too many negatives. I got like a
one. You don't get any ill. You get the sense that that was what their parents believed, but they saw enough violence between their parents to try to learn from their parents' ways.
Uh-huh.
And so they've just, and not to mention, trying to survive on this island with no trees or anything has just, they've had to
adapt.
Yeah, adapt and learn to work together.
Eating a lot of fish.
Laura and John, make another perception check.
Sorry, drop my knife. I make weird noises when I drop things. I'm sorry.
That's
I
okay.
Got.
That's what I do.
What did I get? What is that?
I got a 5.
5?
It's only 11.
I got 30. a 3.
3? You feel almost like you have an electrical current of energy pulsing through your body, through your feet.
I feel weird, guys.
You almost feel like you could fly right now.
Okay, I take off.
Can you fly right now?
Can I try and fly?
You don't.
Oh.
Oh, sad.
Run faster.
Oh, yeah. Can I use this to fly?
Hey, I forgot to ask. Do y'all have haste stones? That seems like important.
Maybe. What's it to you?
Wait, what?
Everyone make a perception.
Did people die or get hurt?
Haste, and haste stones. Perception is a 4 for me.
That's a 1.
5.
4, 5, 4. What'd you roll, John?
4, 4, 4, 5.
Okay.
I don't know about the children.
1.
1? Okay.
They're sticking with me.
So, okay. Everyone but the children.
The children.
Stay close, children.
Those sparkling things in the ground are haste stones.
Oh, shoot.
They're all embedded in the ground, and they just kind of sparkle and shimmer and everything. And, Tony, your character... Something seems weird about the actual, stone beneath, or between the hay stones, but you can't really tell what it is without further.
Their new talk show is between the hay stones.
I'm going to change my vernacular for a moment. Dr. Stein, we need to discuss something.
Sure thing.
Come with me over to this corner, away from grouping of people.
All right.
Look at ground.
Yes, I've noticed haystones everywhere.
But even underneath loose soil and sediment, it seems like maybe large haystone collection. Maybe we roll together for investigation of intelligence. Would you be willing to work with me on this as a team?
Yes, absolutely.
Duh. I will roll my intelligence with his teamwork.
Okay.
Can Tarble taste them?
Yeah, the
Tarble's
fine. I think Kevin is freaking out right now.
9.
So much shiny.
9? Okay. Plus
all the shiny.
Would 11. Be 11.
Yeah. Is it
6?
Can Tarbles use haste stone?
You were just giving him a plus 2.
Yeah. Oh, it's teamwork. Okay. Teamwork.
Yeah.
I like your attitude.
Oh, no. I was going to make it 17.
Yeah, I know.
Okay. So, you notice that it's not like loose soil like you thought. This is solid rock.
Oh, it's like that movie, Return of Superman. It's an island made of one haystone.
Dr. Stein points out, this isn't any kind of rock we have on this planet. And that triggers realization in you, Tony.
You've been triggered.
Dr. Eric. That
it's okay.
This is some kind of asteroid.
And it's an object that has landed here as well.
It's a piece of kryptonite.
Almost vibrating like it's moving.
Can I ask a question?
I may have answer, I may not, but you all should ask question.
So, it's vibrating like it's moving. Do you think it came from a different dimension and this island may disappear?
I would like to ask the islanders. They have a problem with elementals around here because there's a lot of haystones.
What are elementals?
You would know them if you saw them. They, you know,
we're
big rock boys that smash things.
The only,
they smash.
We catch fish to eat, but that's about the only things other than that.
I've been catching up on your studies and studying your studies.
I think we're okay.
Let me think. If rock come to ground. If natural font has opposite pull on this side, maybe it vibrates because it's trying to be sucked in, like if you clog toilet.
It's an astro turd?
I love how everyone
is astroturf. It is astroturf.
Four small children who like
Space Daddy has decided this is astroturf. Okay. It is stuck in clogging the planetary toilet.
Oh god.
We must destroy this.
Again with the destroying.
You want to leave astroturf clogging toilet? Let me get to English language. You want to leave the astroturf clogging the toilet?
You're trying to blow up 5 billion Heashlands? Do you know what kind of damage that's going to do? You really will crack the Earth in half.
Hold on. Let me try English accent for once.
Earth in the general sense.
Yeah, speak English to them so maybe they'll understand you. Obviously, when we do the Russian accent, we're just talking in Russian.
All right, so what's happening here is this island's going to be destroyed because it is plugging all the magic. We remove this, the magic just kind of
free flows again.
Flows everywhere. It's kind of like it's clogging everything. It's a clog or plunging it. There are people here.
Yeah, it's not mine.
Well, they're very bad people.
What?
I know bad people.
You are a bad person. It is true.
He is. He is Dr. What did you call him? Murder Doctor.
So he's like.
I'm not Murder Doctor. I'm Dr. Death. Get it right.
Yeah.
That is true. That is his name.
John and Laura, make a wisdom check.
Yes.
Anyways, yes, I do believe we should destroy this island like you said.
Otherwise, the world is destroyed anyway.
I'm rolling good. Right. I got a. Two.
Well.
I kind of interrupt them.
Do you?
Yes.
Ah, yes. What?
What? Yeah.
Magical perception do you have with your spirit bird?
I don't know. It's not really bird related. He's more.
it's not bird related.
It's not bird related. He's ethereal, but he is of this world. This I'm not so sure about. Kind of.
What?
Something.
Astroturf.
Big yes. world.
It
big
went
words.
Hurtling through space, and then hit the planet, and then I guess it was trying to like bore through to the other side, and then kind of
what?
Stuck.
It's sentient.
It's clogging the tube.
It was trying to
I
do
think
something.
Kind of what it's doing is directing the energy through it, though. You know, because like. With all of these Heashlands here, surely one of them, at least, would have formed a Feldling by now.
Wait, there's a Heashlands?
There's Heashlands everywhere. You see all the sparklies? You see why Kevin's freaking out?
Oh, dang.
Yeah.
All the sparklies.
Those are all Heashlands.
Oh, dang.
If the Heashlands were actually generating magic like they are on the other side of the world, then they would have erupted by now, surely. The whole place would
But the
been
magic from these
alone.
Is being sucked to the other side,
yes.
So what if we find a way to convert the energy back in on itself, freeing this rock from its sediment and making it free float again?
Wait, like how do we
what
know this?
What would happen if we took a Heashlands from here and brought it over to there?
How do we know that this rock
would be higher? How do want to take the person who's pulling the energy in the opposite direction, stop them from doing that, fluctuate the energy back in this direction, freeing this asteroid into space, and then naming it Asteroid Yorktown.
How do we know that this asteroid isn't the source of the energy on the other side, like it always has been?
Because it's...
If we fire that asteroid back into space, is magic gone completely from this world?
Well, there's only one way to know for sure.
Right.
Science.
Science.
Experimentation.
Science for the win.
Is
and then
the
we...
magic you know.
Yeah. So, what do you do?
So, we'll have to create a pull on this side of the axis stronger than the pool that Lord Eris is creating on the opposite side, unless we just travel all the way back across the world and kill him. And that's the only way to stop him from pooling the energy clogging this planet. Those are
why can't we just ask him to stop?
Maybe the two of you join together, and then using the mass plus inertia. I'm not going to quite say it's force.
Physics.
But.
Magic physics.
The force to pull it back in the opposite direction, we can upheave ourselves.
The force. I've heard of it.
Then, if it's actually in space, and this is where I know things, because I am Space Daddy, the magic residue of this rock should keep it sustained, maybe atmospheric in space, so it is its own satellite of this world.
Oh, I like that. Heashman.
A Heashman that causes Heashman. Gravity flow, just like the moon does. So they would still have magical residue on both rocks.
Wouldn't we just have higher and lower tides then, too?
It's fine.
Because there are two
You're
moons.
You're going to be living on the Heashman.
It's global warming. It's fine.
I'm going to be living on the Heashman.
We're on the Heashman right now.
Yeah. Well, potential Heashman.
It's a Heashstation.
It's the Heashstation.
Is there atmosphere on the Heashstation, or are we just going to fire ourselves into space and die?
Well, think about your windstone, right?
Yes.
You can create oxygenated wind.
Yes.
With just the magic of that stone.
Yes.
What?
From things that didn't exist, it does exist. Well, all of these stones on this Heashstation can do the same thing as long as someone knows how to generate the energy within them, which would be the purpose of you staying on the Heashstation.
Can I try and pry the Heashstones out of the ground?
You can try.
What do I need to roll?
Strength.
Oh, I'm good at that. Never mind, I got a 5.
Yeah, you can't even really get your fingers around it.
Can I tarball theft it?
You probably crack it up.
Can I tarball theft
it?
But it's a stunt.
No.
I don't think you can steal it from a rock. Pick the rock's pocket.
Alright.
You can steal anything if you have such a strong enough will.
If you have the will. We are the children of will. We All bring right. the genes of will to
so
aid you.
Okay, so well, if we can get one of the Heashstones from the ground, we can test it to see if it does have magic. By, you know, attempting to use it.
Do our Heashstones work on this island?
Do they? Why don't you
if
test it?
If the magic is being drawn to the other side of the planet, can we
the
even
The science
use magic
of the non-scientist confuses the scientist.
Hey, I've heard of a story about a place that houses an item that negates magic. What's all that about?
That's not important right now, son.
I mean, you're talking about magic not working in one place over another, so I thought it might be important.
If I remember correctly, in your story to me about being locked inside of the big woman tree, you told me that you were able to activate the Heashstone without it being in your possession, correct?
Yes, yes.
Therefore, these stones do not have to be freed from the ground in order to be used. They just have to be activated by someone who is experienced with activating Heashstones.
Maybe he could activate the Heashstone remote.
All right.
Because he's magic.
Heashstone power.
Activate.
I activate the entire island as one giant Heashstone.
Your eyes glow.
Do they? That'd be cool.
Do you have a face to activate them?
Yeah.
Give me 2 faces to activate that many.
Jeez, I'm doing it, guys. I'm doing it. This is for you, Dad.
All right.
I've always believed in you, boy.
John disappeared.
Since I met
him. Oh, I just disappeared.
Oh, crikey! He was the only one I liked!
All right.
I'm
going to take this beard mic off. Set that down.
Come back to me, boy.
What about him?
I work well with him. That doesn't mean we like each other.
We're comrades, let's see.
That is different. Do you not know what comrade means? It means I have agreed not to kill you.
His mother is
If you help me kill other people.
But I don't kill people.
I didn't say you were my comrade.
Right, I'd kill them for you. It's okay.
He's my comrade.
I don't want you to kill them
You're
for
just
me.
A crazy collective of children I have yet to dissect to understand.
And a monkey.
And a monkey.
do not like said monkey business.
It is monkey business, that is true.
Yo, can I move seats?
Reminds me of cartoon back at home. You remember those years?
Cartoons. Every day before the end of the 7-day count, I watched.
Can I figure out where my brother went?
Same here. I remember this one.
And give him a set of dice.
Or this one about these superhero people and you this one stupid monkey. That's what this monkey reminds me of.
Is it a purple monkey?
You know what your session is?
Purple monkeys.
Yeah.
Can I roll?
Yeah.
Well, so probably the best roll you've gotten.
Fine. Okay. What'd you roll?
I got a 5.
You got a 5? You start focusing intently on him, and all of a sudden she disappears as well.
Wait. No, flower mom!
Both of you, come here.
I don't know how I feel about that.
You want me to take my mic off?
Jada!
My helmet is off for this. Well, this is turning out to be interesting. Do you think maybe they went inside the asteroid? Maybe it is sheep? Maybe, I don't know.
They may have cracked the veil.
Maybe they left.
Maybe they took my ticket.
They also took your kid.
And my boy. The one of my pride.
I need flower, Mom. All 5 of me are going through different stages of grief.
At this point, I'm just going to put my helmet back on and be ready for everything's ass. Said something so the kids would understand what I'm saying.
What? I still didn't understand what you were saying.
Oh, why?
I don't understand a lot of things you say.
These children really want to be eaten and dissected.
No, don't eat and dissect me! I need to write that down.
It's a Cronenberg control battle.
Dun 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 dun. Chum played the basket, but it does not.
I told him about carrots earlier. He said, I said they're the most dangerous vegetable out there. I've seen a man kill another man with carrots.
He said it was organic.
They're really good for your eyes.
Ba-dum-tsh. And a bucket of fish.
Oh, full of all the puns right now.
This is my life. He's dangerous, but he's not danger.
Makes me think of that insurance commercial. That guy.
Which one?
The disaster guy. That's always going around and breaking people's stuff. This is what happens. He's got the scratches and stuff.
I love him. I love that guy.
Life's a pretty great aunt.
It's really weird seeing him and John Wick.
Yeah, being a nice guy.
Yeah.
Well, pretty as nice as you can be in John Wick.
That's Massage on Thursday, dude. Hmm? I'm just quoting my list.
Do I know, like, that it's like a vessel of some sort?
That's a massage on Thursday. It's an atomic bomb on a cosmic level. I'm an atomic bomb on a cosmic level.
I feel like the story is evolving off the microphone.
Yeah.
So I know, like, this cable of plot among the stories.
Don't be mad when I kill you.
Shouldn't they be chosen to be on the microphone, though, for story evolution purposes?
I got my microphone sound.
Okay, so should we turn ours off so that y'all are the ones on microphone?
Sure.
Okay.
Everybody turn your mic off now.
Oh, mine was already off. Oops.
Good.
Oh, no. Oh, wait, where's mine? Okay. I'm off now.
I forgot when I turned mine off. I've been talking loud enough for someone else to pick up my voice.
Especially since we're, like, side by side.
Yeah.
What's stuck?
gravity only comes in a can.
If it can't be itself, it's trying. So what?
Yeah. It does. It's called reserve ale.
What?
High gravity beer.
I don't want a jewel pod. You can't make me.
You don't want a what?
A jewel pod.
A jewel pod?
Yeah.
What is that?
I don't want a jewel pod. You can't make me.
That's some of these. It's a brand of e-cigarettes that kids are using. Teenagers.
Yeah. And there was a commercial for one of them on the radio, and so I said that.
Alien things that can appear before. Can I appear before people?
It's bird leg day, okay? Don't judge me in my leg day for birds.
Floating.
She figures out a way you can actually contact them and even
mind calm,
bring them down.
Nobody.
Alright,
everyone's
microphone's back on.
Jada! Father, it is me.
What? Yo, I'm back.
I have developed mind calm abilities.
What's a corridor?
We have our way.
Yes, well, it's one way.
Yeah.
We're already in a way.
But I have to treat him with respect because he worships my cat.
I think it flies amongst the stars, but it's trapped.
Trapped amongst the stars, a vessel of the stars, trapped
in
the atmosphere.
I think it's alive. It's fleshy and it quivers when I touch it.
I left at that last time.
So you brought them down, basically.
I'm going to. I'm like mind calming you to my location somehow.
Take me to your astroflesh.
So are we inside?
It's a Cronenberg ship.
Astroflesh.
Obviously. It's Lex.
So
yes, please take us there so I can
touch it.
Touch it and make it quiver.
No, only I can touch it.
You bring them down?
We must understand.
John, you bring them down?
I'll bring them down.
Okay, you press a few buttons and you guys just suddenly materialize inside.
And I intuitively know how to
give
use
me that materialization.
Now, we are all dressed like cowboys, correct? Except for the armored one.
Yeah.
And this is an alien space.
I'm dressed like the gunslinger from the Stephen King book.
This is kind of like cowboys and aliens, right?
I'm dressed like Spike from Cowboy Bebop.
I enjoy your fashion sense. I am dressed like that old guy you've known for about 2 months.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Tweed underneath leather jacket.
I like it.
Smart yet rugged.
Ronnie, you see...
That doesn't describe you at all.
It's like it's just exactly barely on the borders of your understanding, but you can tell this is some kind of a machine...
where you can get knowledge from, and you can also
program to do stuff, but you just barely grasp that it's something beyond your knowledge, and you're pleasantly curious. Tony, you instantly recognize this as some kind of a spaceship, organic spaceship, like bridge room.
You can see it from outside.
With controls, and there's Heashlands everywhere. There's a viewing screen ahead of you where you can see everyone on the surface of this island that you were on.
Yeah. Yes, yes.
What do you guys do?
I want to access the control panel.
Okay. Give me a minus two because this you don't really know this language that is written in.
Can I add to his perception roll because I'm super magical and have a strange magical bond. I am.
So that's plus two.
Blah, mom is now magic mom?
Yes.
So basically
magic
your roll.
Mom, yes.
Six.
That's
like.
What are you wanting to do with it?
First off, I want a detailed status report. I want to sit rep on the ship. I want to know how it's here. Operational systems and location.
Okay. From what you can tell of the history of this ship, it's part ship, more organic though. It's full of sentient beings that it have somehow evolved beyond beyond their physical form.
Yes.
And they've, for millennia, they've been flying through the universe, and every universe they come to, they basically produce more life.
Give me sentience.
Except for they accidentally crashed into this planet, and they've been trying to turn its propulsions on higher to actually get through the planet, which is what's causing all the magical energy to shoot out the other side and create the fountain and everything.
Oh, so they've been here for a long time.
Yes, very long time.
So I was right.
And they sent these two beings. The only way they could actually, they decided to finally ask for help. And so they sent these two beings.
What does Eris have to do with any of this?
He's sucking up the energy that they're trying to use.
He's using it.
No, he's not. He has no control over this energy at all.
Does he know what's happening, though?
Basically, you two were sent to ask for help in freighting the ship, but there's only so much information that could be transferred through that stream.
So they sent infants?
Well, they sent sentient beings that had to
babies.
Had to be put into a physical form.
You had to grow up again.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
You just did it with lost alcohol.
So hey, I'm not from the mountains life. Of Spolan.
I mean, even like the last month or so has been.
Was it a hard knock life?
Alcohol is bad.
A lot of people died. And then I gained a lot of people somehow. Now I have 4 children and a not husband and a mother and some kind of magic grandpa and space daddy.
Space daddy, get yes. it right.
All right.
No, magic grandpa is Eros. You're space daddy.
Yeah, I'm space daddy. Some people call me Big Papa.
So this thing has been slowly pushing its way through the planet. And it's,
that sounds hazardous to, like, everyone involved in that.
It is. That's the problem. And it's trying to get free and continue its journey through space, seeding life wherever it goes.
Typical.
But it seems to be slowing down. It's having issues. Finally clearing it, clearing the last couple miles. I mean, it will get out eventually, but it'll be another probably million years.
Yeah, well, we can speed that up. I don't have that long. Yeah. I've got things to do, plans to be.
Haha, lame dum dum head, you die.
Huh? All right. The children make weird words a lot, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to eat the monkey.
He's not
no, don't eat my monkey.
He won't eat the monkey. It's fine. The monkey doesn't have a lot of meat on it.
They're plotting to eat my monkey.
I think you're plotting to have yourself eaten. That's what is going on.
No, don't eat me.
No, see, this is one of those occasions in which you need someone to be killed, and I will kill them for you.
But I don't want people to be killed on my behalf.
He's going to eat you.
You constantly ask for bad things, though.
I asked for drugs one time.
You ask for drugs, and then you threaten violence, and then the monkey gets parasitic and infectious, and I don't want disease.
He's not...
What do you guys do?
He doesn't carry diseases.
You said he did. You said he was infectious.
Yeah, with our hive mind.
I mean, personality-wise.
I don't want to be a part of a hive mind. My mind is fine. You come up with weird
Join
words.
Join me.
Okay.
No, I'm Join. Smarter than all of you.
I think we
then
should
Then with our brains combined, we
You
will
would make me dumber.
All.
I don't want that.
No, you would just make all of us smarter. All
Alright, so you're saying, Laura?
Oh, I was gonna say, twin power activate. Let's do some magic, right? Is that the thing we're doing?
That's what I'm doing.
I'm not sure how the magic is gonna
That's work. What I'm gonna do.
If we're super powerful, we're super magical within the font of the magical creature with the sewing.
It's on the other side, though. It's using all its power, like, so we don't really...
getting through to this side.
A little bit.
It was almost there.
It's like the heat from the engines.
It's
so
like
hot that we can kind of feel warmth
away.
In the cabin. But the actual real power is going out the other side through the fount on the other side of the planet.
It's being sucked up and not used, so therefore the momentum is being canceled.
Wasted.
You'll be gonna get wasted?
Imagine...
Is that what you said?
No.
Dang, I wish.
I don't think we do. Like, he's the unintentional villain.
Who?
Yeah.
This Eris fella.
Master Ericus?
Like, Feldenay is this character of, you know, chaos and power user.
Wait a
She's villain,
but,
cracking,
she's,
but
he's villain, but
yeah.
He's like, he's this sort of, like, a faux ethereal, benevolent overlord.
He just does, his old man doesn't understand
yeah,
what's
he
happening.
He sort of pretends to be wise and has no idea what he's actually talking about, apparently.
Oh, dang, that's like actually just the biggest mood.
It's like, what if the Wicked Witch of the West wasn't the bad guy, but the Oz was?
He's, in essence, trying to keep people safe from Chernobyl.
But he's doing so without the full knowledge of what Chernobyl is.
Yeah, but I mean...
So it's like a child picking up a gun and saying, don't worry, I'll shoot the bad guy for you.
See, this is why we shoot the bad guys for the children.
We don't want you to shoot people.
Okay.
Shooting
so
people is
do?
Bad.
So what are we doing? I thought we were going to magic our way out.
Doctor, whatever you do, I will help you. I'll use my alchemy knowledge.
I think that we should hook Jaden and Isis into the ship. It's biological.
Iris.
That's what I said.
Flower mom.
Although the terrorism is really like a mood too, right?
There's also the goddess of the Egyptian
community. I like being a goddess too. That seems to fit.
We hook them into the biological organism.
I believe in
the
you,
ship
you
the way that the
goddess.
Original pilots would have been.
Right.
Yo,
and
we should totally start a cult for you.
Her haystones and your haystone to completely overdrive the ship and power it out.
Let's do it.
Right. I love this plan. Let's do
so
it.
So you're trying to figure out how to get them into the ship?
Yes.
I'm assisting him. He's an alchemy.
I'm going to use...
Are you allowing him to jack you?
What am I doing in the ship?
We're jacking you in.
Okay, but
so
like with that wording...
We're going to make you like the pilots originally were.
I'm going to like...
Like out of Lost Ark?
Biological bond to the ship.
Kind of like trees if they connected to your hair. And
yeah, I was about to say,
the world.
Like if you
yes.
can like bond your braid to your flying dragon.
Yes, we're just going
to
put the
do that.
Hey John,
weird
are you going to let him jack you into the ship?
I inject myself.
Yeah, he's all in, and I'm kind of like, well, I guess.
I'm
going
to use the charisma to bond them with the ship.
You're going to sweet talk the ship.
No, I already have a good rapport.
Well, this persuasion,
with the
so
ship.
It's a biological organism, so are you.
How sentient is the ship, I guess?
I just find
very
a hole in
the
face.
Well,
the
thing is, you don't have to talk the ship
yeah,
into
I
it.
I think
they're
he's, like, ready to go.
Perfectly willing to let you in.
Okay, cool.
Yeah,
we're all
go.
For it.
But
I'm
going to
hook
both
of you in.
The problem is you have to actually figure out how to jack them in. Because the ship recognizes them. The ship wants
like,
them back.
Yeah.
I feel like
well,
we
yeah,
need a
so
different word
yeah,
for that.
Yeah,
you
have high intelligence, right? I've got like 2 intelligence.
My intelligence.
So you're giving him the boost?
No.
Yeah, you can have
7.
My...
7?
Alright, you jack them in.
You're welcome. I'm here to help.
We need a different
yeah.
word for that.
Yeah, that's the correct term.
Jacking in, like to the Matrix?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Plugging into the Matrix.
Or like
Fender.
Or like headphones. You're jacking headphones into the interface.
No, you plug them in.
No, you jack in. You can plug them. It's not a plug.
So you plug them in.
What's your problem with Jack?
What do you two do now? Since you're Jack.
One of my good friend's name is Jack.
You remember everything. You understand everything. You are at one with the ship again.
Is there like, can I turn the radio on?
Yes.
Play some of my ethereal music. It's just,
it plays.
Very tonal and dramatic.
It sounds like the blue opera singer from the Fifth Element.
It's the Blue Man Group. And it's her, but the Blue Man Group is backup. Yes, yeah, so it's and then she's doing.
Weird new age electronic.
Oh no, I changed the station. I'm looking for a Blue Man Group as the backup to the blue girl from the Fifth Element.
With some Enya.
With some Enya overlaid.
And Yanni playing piano.
No. Yeah, but his mic is not plugged in, so he's just there visually.
So he's like playing DJ, and I'm just sort of freaking out with the surreal,
all-knowing
power of...
Of course he is. He's just in the background all the time.
So that means he's singing now.
Yeah, and also he's totally... Believes I'm the Messiah now.
Yeah, so he's an 80s glam then.
Because you are. Right.
Yeah.
I told you you were. All you had to do was believe in yourself.
So, Laura, John, what do you... Okay, you started some music.
Ethereal music. Well, like, I check, like...
The memory banks!
You found the memory bank!
What?
Your memory bank that you wanted.
You can
steal all the memories and put them in your head.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I can store memories I've created in the ship.
He's technically already checked all the memory banks.
Congratulations, my friend.
He can connect to them now.
But I can upload my memories to those banks now.
He's actually more intelligent than you now.
Oh,
that's pushing it.
Upgrade.
Hey.
All right.
So what do you do?
What are you doing? Try to... Figure out.
Are you supposedly more intelligent than me?
All right, well, first off, I shut the engines down.
Okay.
That's the wrong
move. Well, in order to like, so sometimes it takes like, instead of just like, if you're pulling, and maybe you can push and pull and push and pull, and then you can work yourself free. They've just been
that
pushing this whole time.
Deeper. You have to put kitty litter underneath what? The tires.
Okay.
We need a really large plank of wood.
You cut off the engine.
Yeah.
And you see it starting to sink, and you see all the people like panicking because their island, their land is disappearing into the water. Yeah. You just let them float into the water.
So why is it sinking?
Because you just turned it off.
Okay, and then I turn it right back on.
In his mind, that makes it sink.
And
what?
It dropped about 10 feet, and then when you all of a sudden turn it on, it shot forward and stopped at pretty much the exact point that it was at before. But that sudden jolt sends everyone on the surface into space.
Into space. It's a good thing all my friends are inside the ship. Well, we know something.
I don't care about those people.
Is actually like keeping it. Like it's not just a normal thing.
Well, you know,
very
those people should have left the island a long time ago.
At least if we get the ship out, it can seed new life. And, you know, this is all...
Now I'm going to go collect them and then make new life from their bodies.
There you go. Then they will have children. They will have a legacy.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'll just take their brain and then just download the contents and then reform them into the memory bank.
You'll go to each new planet and absorb memories from them. Slowly, your skin will turn green, you'll go bald, and you'll attack a man in a blue suit, but he'll beat you with his hot eyes!
It's the origin story.
You're Brainiac!
Oh, Brainiac. Oh, well. Okay. This is how it starts.
So what are you doing?
He's copywritten, though.
So we turned off the engines and then turned them back on.
Yeah, that did nothing. It killed a bunch of people. That's what it did.
You shot people in space, apparently.
Fire them like super a intelligence.
What are you talking about? You did something great. You rid the world of idiots.
Well, you also did experiment. Now we know. And knowing is half the battle.
Yes.
And I'm the one that's supposed to be evil? Are you kidding me?
Well, I did it.
Science is
on accident.
It's learning.
You did it on purpose. As a difference. Intention does make a difference.
Oh, no, it
I'm going to press button and do it again.
This. This
all right, I would like to have that rant with you.
You turn the engine off again?
Huh?
You turn the engine off again?
when we're over our old settlement, yes, because I want to shoot them into space too.
Sorry, what now?
When we're over where I used to be and I hated those people, I could shoot them into space too.
Well, the only reason they got shot in space is because they're literally on the surface of the ship. And
oh, okay, never mind.
I like basically slingshot.
That was terrible.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sad now. I was going to slingshot some people.
But yeah,
that
like...
That would have been very rude.
Okay, so instead of slingshot...
Okay, so...
I'm a pleasant fellow in this game.
Weapon systems.
It's pleasant to see.
Are there any?
Back to the explosion.
Purifying
high or low?
I'm going with...
Go with medium.
I'm going to go with...
Right in the middle.
50.
Hi.
Hi.
That's
no.
Low. That was all four negatives.
There are no weapon systems. Your race, or alien race, whatever,
right,
had evolved beyond the need for weapons.
That means they must have some means of deconstructing and reconstructing matter without explosive utensils.
Maybe, or they just have shields. Can
shields
I...
Shields can also separate molecules.
Do I have shields? Because I have an idea, and I saw it on a Stephen King short that became a long. It was not good. It was called Under the Dome, and it was so bad, I couldn't stop watching. Anyway.
Okay.
Just like Toxic Avenger.
Yes, there is a shield.
There's a shield. All right.
It's being...
Is it engaged?
You did a thing. It's my turn to do a thing,
well,
bro.
Well, let me give you this wonderful idea.
Who's over there? Let her try it.
If you could, like, use the shield to push away, like, from whatever is keeping us. Like, so you have the ship and the shields are around it. If you could extend the shield a little bit, it might push away the rock or whatever is keeping us.
Let's combine that with my idea. If we can rotate the ship and push the rock away at the same time, we can sort of corkscrew it.
Yeah, I was thinking that too, but then I got the shield idea.
Okay, so we're going to use the shields to sort of push away from the rock as much as possible, which probably won't be much, but as much as possible, and then sort of see if we can rotate the ship, you know, thruster style, so that it can kind of corkscrew.
Ooh, I have one more option, but it will kill a lot of people.
All of this is going to kill a lot
no.
of people.
Okay.
I'm not okay.
Plan B is...
If we're going off of, like, actual physics, this is going to kill a lot of people.
You just turn the engine the opposite way and just shoot out the
other
side.
Yeah, we're not blowing it up. Or are we?
Okay, so you activate the thrusters on... you are now hurtling into space.
What? You did it.
We did it! Hooray! We did it! We did it! Yay! We did it!
And energy exploded everywhere.
Can we collect the people?
But half of me wanted to...
It might not be too late. Well,
Heash is gone.
So that we can use their DNA to make more people.
Heash is gone.
What do you mean Heash is gone?
Okay.
We just rocketed a ship, corkscrewed it into the center of a world,
and
turned it around and repelled ourselves out with force. There's no way physically that planet
survived.
No, it just
went. You didn't reverse out.
We didn't U-turn.
We're in space.
Yeah. Say this is the ship trying to come out. The rock was kind of like that. And so they tried to go like that, didn't work, and they just went around until they found the exit.
Right. With extreme force. I got you.
There's a hole. There's a hole left, and there.
I think Neil deGrasse Tyson should be called in on this.
Well, what'll happen?
I think we're dealing with magic and sentient ships.
There's no more magic
only science
on that planet.
They just didn't understand that it was science that was compelling their magic. Because they were aliens.
But
alien science.
That concludes the Heashlands. The next, or the Heashlands.